In this video, we're going to solve a couple of problems involving electrical charge and current. In the first problem, we're told what the charge is, and we want to solve for the current at a particular time. So here's our function for charge. Notice that it involves an exponential. Notice that the units are millicoulombs. Okay, the little m there is for milli, 10 to the minus 3. And we want to find the current specifically at this time here, a half second. So let me go to my workspace here, and now what I've done, and this isn't, you know, required to actually do the problem, but I think it's good to sketch out what it looks like since it involves an exponential. So just a little review on exponential, that e is equal to 2.718, e to the 0 power, like any number to the 0 power is 1. E to the minus 1 would be 1 over 2.718, which is 0.368. E to the minus 2, 0.135. And you can see the rest here. And I only went down to e to the minus 5, which, you know, is really small, 0.007. So it should make sense to you that the curve would look like this, because at t equal to 0, you'd have e to the 0, which is 1, so 10 times 1. So you got 10 minus 10, which is 0. And then as t gets bigger, the e term here is getting smaller, so 10 times that e term that's getting smaller will also get smaller, and eventually, you know, once you get up to the exponent of e being minus 5, well, now you're going to have 10 times 0.007, which is 0.07, subtract that from 10, and, you know, it's 9.93, so you're getting closer and closer to 10 as time goes on, and you probably learned in your math that this type of curve, it's called asymptotic, meaning that it never reaches this final value, which is 10 in this case, until t is equal to infinity. So that's just a little review of an exponential function, but now to actually do the problem that's asked, we go back to what we talked about the previous video, that current is equal to the derivative of charge. So dq dt, that's our current. Okay, so we just need to take the derivative of this up here. So derivative of a constant 0, so now we have the derivative of minus 10 e to the minus 2t, which you're going to get minus 10 times minus 2, which is 20, and then e to the minus 2t, and then this is going to have units of milliamps since we start with millicoulombs, and then we're asked specifically what the current is at half a second. So now if we evaluate this expression right here at t equals to a half, we're going to get that the current is equal to 20 e to the minus 1. Okay, and e to the minus 1, as I have written up here, okay, right here, is 0.368, so multiply that by 20, and it comes out that our current is 7.36 milliamps. All right, that's our answer. Okay, so anytime you want to get the current from charge, it's taking a derivative. So now let's look at the second problem that I have on this handout here, and that's, we're told what the current is, and notice that the current function changes with time. So if we're within this time interval of 0 to 1 second, it's 2 amps, but if we're at a time greater than a second, well, then it's 2 t squared amps. And we want to find the total charge from t equal to 0 to t equal to 2 seconds. So this time interval that we want to find the charge, it spans over these two time intervals. So what we'll have to do to solve this problem is we're going to have to integrate. Okay, because to get charge from current, it's an integration operation. And since our current function changes over the interval that we want to find the charge for, well, we have to break this up into two integrations. Okay, from 0 to 1, we're going to integrate 2 dt, and from 1 to 2 seconds, we're going to integrate 2 t squared. Okay, so what we'll get here, okay, the first one, we're just going to have to evaluate 2t from 0 to 1. And for the second integration, we'll have to evaluate from 1 to 2, we'll have to evaluate 2/3. 2/3 t cubed. Okay, so this one here, plug in the limits, we're going to get 2 minus 0. In here, we can write this as, so you can take the 2/3 out. And that, let's see, that would be t cubed is 8, and then 1 cubed is 1. Okay, so we'll have 2 plus 14/3. Right, which 14/3 is 4 2/3, so add 2 to that. And the answer is 6 2/3, and that's coulombs. We started with amps, so coulombs. Okay, and that's the answer there. So when you're getting, or you want to solve for charge from current, you'll have to do integration. All right, well, next video, we'll talk about voltage.